Hello world! Welcome back to this new video. The video I made 2 months ago about Zeal 8-bit OS seems to really have aroused your curiosity. I received a lot of good remarks and suggestions, and I thank all of you for that. If you haven't watched it yet, I advise you to have a look at it first. Today, I would like to talk about Zeal 8-bit OS again, and more precisely, writing programs in assembly or even C for it. Let's get started. If you follow the development of the OS on GitHub, you may have noticed that a new directory is now present. It's called kernel headers. Yes, as its name states, it contains header files that can be used to create user programs. But not only this, the header files also act as a documentation for the kernel interface. At the moment, Z88DKs, Z80ASM, and SDCC are supported. The first one lets you write programs in assembly, while the latter lets you write programs in C. Let's take a quick look at the headers for Z80ASM assembler. The file zosys.asm is the main one. It contains an explanation for the kernel's constants and the syscalls. In fact, as you can see, the syscalls are represented as macros. For each syscall, you will find a macro accompanied by its description, its parameters, and its return values. We will see how to use them later. Let's take a look at the newest part, the headers for C programs. In the SDCC directory, you will find the headers in include. Each C header contains information about a particular subset of syscalls. The ones related to the files, directories, and drivers is zosvfs.h or zosvfs.h. Inside, just like the header we have already seen, we will find a description and an explanation for each syscall, including the parameters and written values again. Moreover, as C is more typed than assembly, there is also an explanation about the structures that are used to communicate with the kernel. For example, we have the directory entry structure or the file's status structure. The other header files follow the same pattern, while describing other syscalls related to time, errors, and memory. Okay, we have header files for C, but that's only function signature, so how does it work underneath? For the assembly headers, it's fairly easy. We put our parameters in the registers the kernel is expecting, and we execute the syscall instructions, which is in fact an RST8 instruction in our case. But in C, we don't manually assign the registers. So how to interact with the syscalls from C? More precisely, how does the C compiler know in which registers parameters must be put in? Well, it doesn't know, and this is where the compiler's calling convention comes in. The convention will tell us how the compiler arranges the parameters given to a C function into the CPU registers. Thanks to this, we can make a layer between the C functions and the assembly syscalls, and this is our header implementation. Let's check the documentation of the C compiler I will be using, SDCC 4.2.0. The part we are interested in is 4.3.3, Z80 calling conventions. It states all the conventions that are supported. We have SDCC call 1, SDCC call 0, small c, Z88DK, etc, etc. Let's see the default one, which is also the one I chose to implement in Zeal 8-bit OS headers implementation. Small reminder, the Z80 processor has 7 8-bit registers, which are A, B, C, D, E, H, and L. But it can pair B with C, D with E, and H with L to get 3 16-bit registers, namely BC, DE, and HL. Alright, back to the SDCC calling convention version 1. Here is what it says. If the first parameter is 8-bit, like char type, it goes in register A. If the first parameter is 16-bit, like short type, it goes in register HL. If the first parameter is 32-bit, like long type, it goes in registers HLDE. Now for the second parameter, it becomes a bit more complex as it will also depend on the first parameter size. If the first one is 8-bit and the second one is also 8-bit, the latter goes in L, but if the second one is 16-bit, it goes in pair DE, else it goes on the stack. The remaining parameters, if any, also go on the stack. If the first one is 16-bit and the second one is also 16-bit, the latter goes in DE pair, else it goes on the stack. Same here, the remaining parameters also go on the stack. If the first parameter is 32-bit, all the remaining parameters go on the stack. As such, the order of the function parameters in SDCC matters. It's important because manipulating the stack is slower than registers on the Z80. Knowing this, it's possible to write a glue layer between the code generated by SDCC and Zeal 8-bit OS. This layer needs to be written in assembly and will move the parameters to the registers expected by each syscall. Let's take the function IOCTL as an example to see how it works in practice. Dev parameter is 8-bit. It will be placed in A register. CMD command is also 8-bit. It will be placed in L register. And arg will be placed on the stack. On the other side, the IOCTL syscall expects the opendev to be in H, the command number to be in C, and the arg parameter in DE. So, we have this routine that acts as a glue. The command is moved to C, the arg is popped out of the stack and stored in DE, and the opendev is stored in H before calling the syscall. And that's it. Pretty simple, right? This is the case for most of the functions implementations. You can find the source code for all of them in zeal8bitos.asm file. I will put a link in the description. This glue between the compiler and the kernel needs to be implemented for each compiler we want to support. And this is why only SDCC 4.1.12 and above are supported at the moment. These are the versions that support such calling convention. So, is that it to support C? We only need to make the kernel syscall accessible in C? Well, not really. We should also implement what is called the CRT0. CRT0 is a set of routines that will set the global and static variables to the values they were defined with, or zero if they were uninitialized. It can also perform any specific operation required by the operating system. It is from there that the main function is called. And this is why you will also find on the GitHub repo the file named zoscrt0.asm. The code inside is the first one executed when a user program is loaded by the kernel. It will prepare the global and static variables, as I just said. It will also call the main function. And after main returns, it will also call exit syscall to tell the kernel to unload the program. Let's see a small demo. I have written a small C program that opens the current directory, browse all the entries while printing the name of each. Then it closes the directory and exits with a message. To compile it, I type make. It will show me that the binary has been generated correctly. The fastest way to test it now is to embed it inside the ROM disk, which will be included in the OS image. So I can use the newly implemented environment variable extra ROM disk file to include it inside the ROM disk. And now that this is done, I can test it on the emulator first. I load the image. I check if the file is here. I execute it. And yes, it works. I can see all the files that are in the current directory. And in fact, I can also test it on the real hardware. Let's have a try. And yes, it works too. Great. So that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. As usual, if you have any question or suggestion, leave a comment down below and see you next time.